Welcome to the second video outlining my Graymason game, where I spawn in the southeast corner, allied with the notorious Dex Jackson. You can see we're picking up at cycle 11, and the reason is at this point in the game, we are past that beginning forming an alliance perspective and looking to mid game. And this is really where a lot of the key strategic decisions get made. So let's flip over to the alliance map that I pulled together. And as you can see here, we have the good guys in the bottom. And so I am with Dex, Tinfoil, Captain Morgan, and Earth Force Alliance down in the southeast quadrant. In the center, we're dealing with Prince Griffin, Lady Lilia, Scare, and Slow. Now, that crew has originally said they wanted to attack us. And my bottom three alliances of Dex, Tinfoil, and Captain Morgan are actually engaging Scare now, and looks like Lilia is coming to assist. So that's going to be a big confrontation that I hope we come out on top with. We should. Prince Griffin and I have been chatting about pushing into the northeast, and that is one of the options that's on the table. And Slow is pushing into the northeast. But the biggest threat on the board right now is this northwest crew. You have Thing 1, you have Eon 6T, you have Danny DeVito clone, and you have Nat 20, who was pressed the attack. Oh, and Kane. So that crew there is, I think, the biggest threat in the game right now from everybody's perspective. They have no real opposition in the north yet, although the northeast crew is going to be butting heads with them, and the southwest crew is not really a thing yet. Now, the southwest has Dr. Gert, who is strong, but it just that there's always like one area of the galaxy that kind of evolves or gets stronger slower than the other. In this game, it's that part of the map. So right now the strategic conversation is we don't have a lot of choice. Our bottom three have to push into Scare, and at that point they can push to the center or the southwest to grow bigger. But for Earth Force Alliance and I, this is really coming up to a pivotal point in the game. Do we work with Prince Griffin, if he's willing, to fend off Pyrodre, who's coming south? Now, Pyrodre also told us that Mr. Lethalblood is also, which is the teal diamond, is also coming south. If there's four of us kind of colliding in the center on the eastern side, that's problematic. So if I worked with Prince Griffin, we could probably push them back into that side. The problem, I think, is that doing that, and then if the northwest crew pushes the northeast crew back on the north side, that just strengthens the northwest crew overall, and then the center gets consumed or attacks us because we're attacking their southern allies. I think that's a bad play. So I think the right play here is to actually form an agreement with Pyrodre, with the Jewish Star Empire, who's that little empire of orange in the top, with that northeast crew, and help them push back the northwest crew while we get stronger in the center. I think that's the right play, and I think I'm going to start to try to put that into motion. The question now is going to be, how do we get my alliance, Earth Force Alliance, and I to grow and give Pyrodre a place to grow enough that he feels satisfied as well. And so if I can do that, then I think that's the best long-term strategy. Let's see if I can pull something off and how this next really week of mid-game goes. Cycle 13, I pulled it off. I did it. I'm going to link above the video. So basically, I created a video, had conversations with Dre, and I just articulated how I saw this all playing out. And you can watch my logic. I re-articulated it into a thread that I called the Massiver Eastern Alliance. And the reason is because I basically said you have this massive alliance in the northwest, and they're starting to pull in the center. And they're making a very massive alliance. And the only way that you beat a massive alliance is one that's more massive or massiver. Little funny play on words there. So there it was. I invited 10 people into an alliance and basically said, you have these two already going this way. Take Mr. Lethal Blood, so you have three up top. We already have three players pushing the south. They'll keep doing what they were doing. You have me and Earth Force Alliance pushing to the middle. Now we'll be joined by Dre. So we have three, three, and three. And I think by the time they figure out what's going on, it's too late. So I said, yeah, I'm being honest. I want to win. I think this is the best way to win. You can pause and read all of it. You can watch the video, but it's a go. So we have a separate thread now with Dre, Earth Force, and myself, and it went back away. But basically, Dre went through and said, yeah, let's start. Right, let's do this. One of the decks has been having side conversations. That guy makes me so nervous. But he is aligned at least for now with what we're doing, so fine. And then we set some boundaries, and it's totally agreeable. So here we go. I'm pushing in. All these stars are going to be Earth Force Alliance. I'm just trying to get rid of them. You have Prince Griffin, who's pretending to be on our side, but he's been feeding weapons to Cindercats. Like, he's got four signs, and in the last 24 hours, he went up weapons again. And there's literally no one else around them that could give him. So he is thinking he's being sneaky, but make no mistake, he will pay dearly. He was going to pay dearly either way. So it's actually a good move on his part. But he doesn't know that because right now he thinks we're going into the northeast. Unless I'm being played and this is not the plan and Dre is going to attack me. But I think he's on board. I think this is going to happen. So, really, really big pivotal moment. The Massiver Eastern Alliance will push west and then we'll see how I can come out on the top of this alliance. But I think it's going to involve a lot of very greedy star taking. I got it in the bag. We are on cycle 14 of the Pink Star game. The Massiver Alliance is going well. Since yesterday, I was able to claim a bunch of stars up here. A few little minor run-ins with Prince Griffith, who's still trying to be sneaky. I think he thinks I don't know what's up, but whatever. So I'm also being facetious with them. Like, I'm like, oh, hey, this was Cindercat. So I told him, like, that's my star. But you can see, let me just show you where my, he's like, and now you're sending stars to a ship I'm already sending. If you could reroute them, I'm like, yeah, not cool. This is the second time you did it. So I'm just taking your stars that were Cindercats. So that's one thing. And then I had Lady Lilia. Her you might be looking for some allies. Basically, like, I led them on to believe I was going to attack my southern allies, and mainly just to get information, mainly because I was bored. But no intentions of ever doing that. And then I just basically said I was about to attack, which of course I wasn't. And so, I don't know. I was just being silly, letting them know that I was annoyed with them, because it doesn't change a thing. But apparently, that got back to my alliance, and so there was this. Let's let Dex Jackson say it best in his own words. Dex, let us know.
Ahem. 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 I told you. You didn't listen. And I told you again.
Yeah, I didn't listen.
And again.
And he did.
You didn't listen.
I didn't.
I know you must like KFC Graymason, cause you bout to get this two-piece combo right here. A
Okay.
little OTHA left.
Crispy chicken. I
A
like
little of
crispy.
THA right.
A little of that.
You want coleslaw with that?
I do.
That guy is cancer. This is what I sent to those dumb fucks in the center from the start, and they still didn't listen.
Yeah, So Dex is offering some KFC chicken with coleslaw. I don't know. I did get annoyed with him though, because I told him I was playing with him, and then he and I paid him to give me scanning, and then he was like, "Hey, we need to get." Basically, he's like, "We need to get." Wait, where is it in the text chain? Here we go. Hold on, let me go to the text chat. This is worth. This is like the. This is why you're watching this video, right? Like all the nonsense. Yeah, guys, we can't do anything until they get weapons. When are we going to get the weapons? And basically, we're just trying to get in range of scanning. But I sent him scanning. I'm like, hey, that scanning I paid for that you didn't send because you're mad at me? That would help to get in range. So as soon as this lands here in now 11 hours, with the range that he has, he'll be in range to Dre. And in like a little bit less time or a little bit more time, Dre said he'll be on, I think, one of these two. I'm not sure. Not sure which one of those. So in the next day, we are going to sync up, and then we're going to get a double boost of weapons, terraforming. We'll give them some stuff. I'm trying to get more range just to be do something productive, and then I'll swap over. So anyway, that's where things stand. A little bit of tension with my alliance. Dex is just a constant source of entertainment. But yeah, they were talking big. We're going to do this and sweep in, blah, 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 blah. They like took 2 stars and then they're stuck. So that's a little disappointing in my southern allies. They can't three on one, three on two. They can't even take a couple stars. So that's all right. We're going to save the day. We're going to bust through the middle of Dre. Earth Force Alliance, who's playing like a stud. And we're going to break this middle of this map open. Cycle 15, we are cruising now. Good things are happening. We have synced up with Pyro Dre, and look at that beautiful tech. We are no longer trailing behind. And zooming into the center, we actually now are ahead in weapons, and things are looking good. We've basically Cindercat is about to blow up into our friend Earth Force Alliance, and he will be out of the game. Rubik AI about to be cleaned up. F is almost gone, and we're fully united. So in the center, we actually have Dre in range. He's doing his Dre things. Earth Force is just about to launch from Tax here, and I warp gated this star for him, so he's going to be coming up this way. I've absorbed as much as I could. I had like 500 fleets. I've just been absorbing. Actually, said another 400. So I've take about 1,000 fleets just to absorb for my alliance, but everything else. So basically, this star down is mine, and then west. So these are all for Earth Force, and I'm just trying to absorb as much as I can, because when I did launch, Prince Griffith got a little upset. So let's just take a little bit of a stroll through last night. He had this whole thing. We both hate Dex, and what, right? So I don't hate Dex. Matter of fact, I think he's hilarious. But I told him he annoyed me, which is actually not hard to convince people that Dex would be annoying. But I love him like a brother. But basically, I launched on him, and then it was the light bulb. It's like, if you're truly against him, make sure you move, blah, blah, blah. And then, GG, to be honest, I was a bit too trusting of you, and it's a fair play. What really threw me is, why did the Jewish Star Empire try to get me to help Cindercats and attack you before you could reach Dre? Was it just mind games? Well, the truth of the matter is, and here's the answer if you're watching this Prince Griffith later, I fully intended to attack the Northeast. I fully intended to work with Prince Griffin and attack the Northeast when I thought the Northeast was the biggest threat. But on Monday, when I looked at the state of the board and said, if I do this, then that, I realized that was a mistake. Now, Dex had said that all along. He was right. But I do not just take for face value when anyone says. I kind of do my own research. And So then I came to that realization. That's why I kept my door open on both sides. And that's why I made that video and said, okay, we need to make this Eastern massive alliance. So it was not anything that you did other than the state of the map, and that it made sense that if I attacked Dex, I am making myself vulnerable. I will say that Prince Griffin was selfish, opportunistic, and n at no point did I feel like he was really gonna be on my side. Where with Dre, and maybe I'm being misled, I have 100% confidence that Dre will do his best to either win or to help his alliance win. And I'm very confident that Dre will not stab us. But anyway, you can read the rest. So that was like an exchange with Griffin. Now, obviously, we'll let the rest of our alliance know. And I'll do a quick little scan. This is what I got from Captain Morgan. So this is down in the southwest. You can see he's like, hey, this is one of the first little bits of intel I had. You can see that Dex is going in on Scarer, that Lady Liliana is in play. I didn't add it all up, but it looks like we're going to be able to start pushing now that we have weapons. But then we had a little outburst, and so let's have Dex, in his own words, do it. Now I'm trying different free text-to-voice readers, so this I know the gender may not be right, but it might be right. Who knows? Dex, take it away.
I gotta admit, it's fun sometimes messing with a roasting Graymason.
Yeah, it
He
is.
isn't a shit talker or aggressive back though,
I
takes the juice out a
can't.
little.
I can be.
Sometimes, it's no fun being one of the last players with toxic badges around.
Well,
And
he's
dude,
earned
if it's
it.
not clear, the intel, that's fine. I'm not surprised by what he said, nor is he doing anything I didn't already expect him to do. It's still appreciated.
He's talking about Prince
The
Griffin.
point is, people are gonna do what they're gonna do dash. It just bemuses me what it takes before it's too late for them, or they do what was advised in the first place, but it's harder
Well,
now. And they are
I
like, oh
disagree with
shit,
that.
sorry bro, Or WTF man is your problem man, leave me alone, I ain't did nothing man. So I'm gonna give them a hard time dash, as I should.
Well,
Anyway, and this is serious time now, be careful up
okay,
there with
serious
Pyro
time.
Dre.
Be
Be
careful.
really, asterisk fucking asterisk careful Grey Mason. My
Yeah.
instinct is kicking in, something up ahead.
Nah,
You two Earth Force Alliance.
I'm pretty good. I'm pretty good
I
with
do
Dre.
actually give a shit about you two, you do know that. Do not make
He
a
loves
beeline
us.
for Lady Liliana.
Okay, so don't
Go
go.
past him to Kane.
Just go
You
right
gotta
past
think
them
like
to
this a
Kane.
theater.
It's a theater.
And
Okay.
we were asterisk always asterisk talking about chicken. Totally. Chicken is good.
Chicken is good.
I make great fried chicken by the way dash. Got
Oh.
a small burn for it as an Epicurean souvenir.
Oh, very cool.
Okay, just read your post. There seems to be some major misunderstanding.
Okay, tell
Like
me.
major.
Really?
Like you thinking I'm coming at you instead of bro, you're better than this.
Oh, okay.
Never a problem with you attacking Prince Xerxes Griffin XVIIIAT all.
Oh, okay.
That's literally what I expressed would be a great idea in the first place dash, weeks ago.
Oh, okay,
You're doing
great.
exactly what was most helpful in the first place.
I'm glad I have your
It's that you
approval.
still thought diplomacy, subterfuge, etc. with him would be useful. It never would be.
Never?
You genuinely considered working with Cancer
I
Dash, and
did.
I know you did.
I did. I true,
It's
totally
only
true.
him being as fucking vile as he is that you've changed approach.
Not true. That's not
And you've
why.
acted as though that's a asterisk new asterisk realization.
Well.
That's fucking asterisk terrifying asterisk, Gray. Holy shit. I
Well.
almost had to call in a favor with Kane because of that.
Don't know what that means. So, yeah, so let me explain. I think I already have. Basically, I thought the Northeast was the biggest threat, and I was going to work with this guy to take care of it. Once I realized the Northwest was the biggest threat, I said, no, I got to work with the Northeast, and I don't care what Dex or anyone else tells me, I'm going to make sure that that's what I think is the right thing to do. He's telling me, do not stop and fight Lady Liliana. To just go right to Kane, which I'm not sure how honestly that works. So, like, let's just say I go this way along this northern edge and fight Kane. Now, I think here's my honest opinion. I think Dex is always trying to, he thinks he's outsmarting people. And so what he thinks that if I were to do that, right, ignore Lady Liliana, right, that allows him to push in and take all those stars. Because I think at the end of the day, that's what he wants. He's like, how do I, if Gray takes these stars, I can't get those stars. I don't think he's really like, because it makes no sense. Like, I would get cut off. If I'm attacking Kane, she's going to be attacking me the whole time. Like, I have to fight. You can't just ignore. They're not going to let me just walk past you. So I think this is just a selfish play on Dex's part. I do not think he has my best interest in mind. I think it might help him. But I think we can win either way, and I think I'm better off taking just pushing in and then taking. If I can get this entire cluster myself, are you kidding me? I win the game. If he gets that cluster, he could win the game. So I think he knows damn well what he's saying, and I'm not listening to that. The one other thing that I just thought was funny that I would share was, oh, by the way, yeah, I think Earth Force and Dre are my best allies this game. Tinfoil would be great. He's just been neutered by Dex cutting him off, and Morgan's been neutered. I think Dex is kind of trying to play master, puppet master, and that's the bigger issue here. But yeah, so the other thing that I thought was interesting. Where is it? Ah, okay. So the other thing that I thought was interesting was this little thing here where it's like, I'm going to start smashing science and switch to weapons. I will not let that happen again where we get fucked on weapons. We would have been. Okay, so here's what he said. So we got behind, right? We got behind because he just stayed on scan. Like, no, like, we tried to do weapons, but we just got behind. So we would have been at that star and that star by now. This coalition we're in with the Northeast is fragile at best. I'd rather we be ahead of what is to come. There's no world in which they were up here and over there by this time in the game. Now, they've been sitting idle. They couldn't move. But that was the only reason that they're not progress is because for the last week, Dex said, "Don't attack. We're waiting for this mast his master plan." Like, he just said people to attack literally like 2 days ago, and you would not have been all the way over there and up there by then. So he's so full of it. But whatever, I don't care, because I do think now that we have this now that we're with Dre and his crew, we're gonna push into the middle. They're gonna slow push down there, and now we'll just see how the rest of the board reacts, because they could unite. And the other thing that was interesting is this Eon 6T quit. I thought he was with the Northeast Alliance, Northwest Alliance, and he's not. And this player still is has quit. So you're gonna have basically Thing One consuming all those while this what is this, the Danny DeVito clone? Yeah, is fending off the Northeast. So it's gonna be Thing and Kane and Nat 20. And they'll probably align with Dr. Gert. If I can not click on a, yeah, Dr. Gert. I assume that's going to be our end game group that we're fighting against. But so we just have to basically get more stars than them by the time we collide, and we'll crush this middle section. All right, longer update, but yeah, things are about to get real. In 1 hour, I land. I will warp gate, get great vision, and start to claim some stars. Cycle 16, here we are. We've made landfall on this cluster of stars. It was previously princes, and they are now pretty much all mine. Didn't have a lot of resistance, didn't think I would. And I have all my reinforcements streaming in, some cleanup occurring, back behind here, but the cavalry's coming. I did take quite a bit of a hit, kind of the brunt of Prince's forces, so I'm a little bit depleted from like where Dre's at now, a couple thousand, 2,000 almost under, or we even before. You get a sense of the intel here on total ships. You can see I flatlined for a bit taking this cluster over, but that's okay. And more importantly, you see Kane rolling in. to the rescue. So he's now, I'm assuming, going to slowly push out down in the south here. Yeah, I don't know how slowly. He's pushing out in the south, but still sending some support to the center. So it's going to get interesting. We're nearing end game, where it's just kind of the last few big forces duking it out. So Earth Force Alliance is about to launch and get up to the front lines. Dre is on his way. And then once these two guys kind of catch up with me, I kind of had a bit of a lead while they were doing cleanup. It'll be real interesting to see if we can just keep pushing, or if we stalemate, or they push us back. Prince Griffin does not have much. We're actually ahead on, or even with weapons. Actually, yeah, hold on. I think we're, they're at 11. Dre, I think, is like half a cycle ahead. And my terraforming actually finishes this tick. So they're at 11. So, yeah, I mean, basically, you're looking at now, here's how it's looking. It's got Kane, Thing One as the top two, and then probably, and then Danny DeVito, Nat, those probably the top three, but then Lady Liliana and Slow are, like, that's the whole crew, right? So you got there, like this cluster here is the bad guys. Hopefully our northern folks are able to start to make some progress once we start to put some pressure on from the south. It does look like the southern guys are making some progress. One thing of note, Tinfoil has said he is out. He's, never really able to get going, a little frustrated by the position, understandably. And so I took 6 stars, Dex has taken 6 stars, and Captain Morgan will take 6. It'll honestly help us out. I feel bad because I think he's a strong player, but he just was never able to get going. So now the south is just going to be Dex and Captain Morgan. So they're not particularly strong yet. They've been kind of stalemating and taking a little bit longer, but neither is Scare. And Lady Liliana, well, she had like 10 fleets like last cycle. So most of her stuff's going to be up here. So I'm actually glad to see her starting to get more fleets to get them out of the way, because I don't really want to fight her right now either. I would like just to get a foothold and, well, we'll see. I think we'll just have to react to what's happening. But anyway, that's where we're at. Feeling pretty good still overall. Oh, I went through the bad guys, good guys, right? So myself, Dre, Earth Force, Dex are at the top. And then up in the north, you do have Eborg and Fijo that are doing well. And Lethal Blood, once you see him creeping his way to the front lines. So I think once he gets up there, they'll start to make progress as well. So, I give ourselves, 66% chance, two-thirds of to push him back, and we'll see where it goes from there.
We are in the final hours of Cycle 18. As you can see, the push into the middle has been successful. We're down to 1, 2, 3 stars from Prince, and we're claiming those here now. He'll be off the map soon. We have Dre, who's been able to successfully push in and really is hitting Slow. And Slow now is having to defend, and you can see his ship count is low. He's falling behind in tech. And in addition to Dre hitting him, he's getting Vijo, who's starting to take some stars. We actually have Mr. Lethal Blood, who's gotten to the front lines. So Slow is starting to slowly fall. Then you have Lady Lilia, who basically is trying to negotiate strongly with me that I can't take her stars, which is silly because I'm just going to do it. I really want to get to Kane. I do think Dex is right. I mean, you look at the leaderboard, Dex is the by far biggest threat. Really, what the big threat here in this game? It's Thing One. It's Kane and it's Nat 20. Those three are the top three on the enemy team. If things go, these other players in the middle are just a buffer and they're just stalling while these other three get strong. And so they'll have the three techs they need. They'll be stronger than any individual for us. So we really do need to get to them soon. So that's why we have to get through slow quickly. We have to get through the Danny DeVito empire here, and we have to get through Lady Lilia. Down in the very south, Cain did start to colonize, and he then, as Dex started to try to get in here on Tiernan, he got a weapon boost. So now we have to weapon boost Solara. Not him. We have to weapon boost Solara. Oh, looks like we did. Okay. So I guess the question is, if we didn't do that, then is did Cain do that to try to fight us? We really want to get these yellows fighting the west and not the east, because if you look at the map, the line is right about like this, right? We have over half the map that we're fighting, so it would be good to get at least some of them on our side. Which is all the reason why we need to quickly dispatch of this middle section. So, like I said, things are looking pretty good. We finished off one enemy. Slow will definitely fall. And now it's a matter of, I assume then these guys up here can pivot and start pushing into this corner while the three of us continue to push Kane back in the center. Although you can see we're going to start to deal with Nat 20, press the attack soon enough. So that's where things are looking. Let's do a quick scan. Just, I don't know that we've done this in a while. We'll go to on the total star count. I'm up top, but you have Thing One and Kane pulling away. On the economy, I'm doing decently, but you have Thing One and Kane at the top. On the industry, I think I'm second, but you still have Kane substantially ahead. On the science front, you have Dre and I doing pretty good. Earth 4, so here's our top three, but Kane with weapons way ahead. Ship count, Dre finally made landfall. I'd been taking the brunt of the hits in the middle, but Lady Lily is lower. But Thing One and Kane, so it's Thing One, Kane, and then Nat 20 a third, but he's gonna pick up ground. So yeah, because he's not fighting anyone yet. So that's really kind of what it's looking like right now. It's Kane, Thing One, and Nat against me, Dre, and Earth Force Dex, I think are the main player. But yeah, we'll see. It could go either way still. So it's getting actually close to the end game, and maybe now that things are really solidified, maybe go into video three now and do a recap from there of end game, because we truly now just this is just end game fighting of East versus West. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this, click on the link for the next episode, and don't forget to click subscribe for more content.